Hi friends, welcome back to Angular Unit Testing series. In this series, I am talking about unit testing in Angular using Jasmine framework. In the last video, I have explained about how we can test routing in Angular. In this video, I am going to explain about code coverage in Angular unit testing. Let's start. What is code coverage? In Angular unit testing, code coverage determines how much amount of code is covered as part of unit testing. In other words, it estimates how much of our code is tested. Code coverage is also called as test coverage. Let me show you how we can generate the code coverage report. Let me open the same application we have used so far. And let me run this command. ng test --no-watch and then --code-coverage. We are using --no-watch because now we don't want to rebuild it every time the file is changed. And we are using --code-coverage to output a code coverage report. Let me press enter. Okay, it is completed. From here itself, we can see that we have covered this much percentage of statements, branches, functions, and lines of code. Also, we can see a new folder called coverage has been generated with some files. Let me open this index.html. Here it shows an in-depth view. We can see we have a good coverage, more than 90% approximately. If you cover more than 80%, it will be considered as good coverage. Some of the clients set this as 70%. If the code coverage falls below 70%, mostly they won't agree to deploy the code in production. In that case, we need to work on to increase the code coverage. How can we improve the coverage? Here we can see info component is covered only 75%. If I click this, we can see this go back function is not covered. And let me click this app folder. Here we can see except grade directive, all others are 100%. Let me open the grade directive. We can see we have tested the mouse enter, but we missed to test the mouse leave. Let me handle that now. So in grade directive spec, let me quickly copy this. It should revert the text color on mouse leave. Let me change all these events to mouse leave. And let me expect all these to be black. Okay, let me rerun the coverage report. Okay, it is completed. Let me refresh the index.html. Now we can see everything inside app folder is 100%. Like that, we can increase the code coverage. But keep in mind, as this is a small application, we have achieved a good code coverage percent. But when we work on big applications, it will be difficult to achieve more than 90% code coverage. Also, as part of this series, I have tried to cover as much as topics possible. But you should understand that it will be difficult to cover all the scenarios. My idea is to give an overview of how we can perform unit testing in Angular. For example, I have covered how we can test a simple directive. But in your applications, you may need to test a complex directive. You can take my video as a base, and when you struggle on something, you can refer Stack Overflow for help. Even for routing, I have covered simple routing. But there may be routing with params, child routes, protected routes, etc. The idea is going to be same, but some syntaxes or some configurations change. Sometimes you may need to use synchronous code, sometimes you may need to use asynchronous code. Everyone cannot remember everything in unit testing because we rarely use unit testing in developing Angular applications. So far, I have worked on more than 20 to 25 real-time Angular applications. But I have used unit testing in less than 5 applications. So I believe this Angular unit testing series gave you a good understanding on unit testing. Please like this video and support me. I'll be back with next series soon. Thank you. Bye.